Good morning. So glad that you're with us today on this Resurrection Sunday. I've been looking forward to it all week, honestly, for several weeks. I always look forward to this day. I hope that you do as well. We had a good early morning service. We did not brave the cold. We chickened out and we stayed in here. Wind was a bit nippy, so we stayed in here, but we welcome you to our service here this morning. The service will be a little bit different. We're going to sing a few more songs, and then we're going to have a dramatic reading of the whole resurrection account. And everything has been very much a lot of thought and prayer has been put into all these things. So I hope that it's a blessing to your heart and an enjoyment for you. Let's go ahead and look at our announcements. And then we will begin in singing praises to the Lord. So we are on week 16 of our Bible reading program this week. And then favorite requests. So if you didn't hear before or if you forgot about it, so in the evening we usually do favorites and testimonies. And we're trying something a little bit different. Gives you a little more time to think of a favorite. We have a little jar in the foyer, on the table in the foyer, that you just write down on the sheet of paper the name of your song, the number, and the songbook it comes from, or if it's no music for it, but just check that box. And it doesn't have to be from our hymnal. If it's from an old hymnal, from a chorus book, or some other hymnal out there, we'll find it. So if you want to sing it, well, just put it in there and we'll do that. So that's how we're going to try this for a bit. Our song leader will, the week before, he will pull out three or four songs, and then we will sing them. So think of some songs, think of some favorites. As we get closer to Christmas time, we'll get a different colored paper for Christmas songs, and you can pick your favorites of those. So please participate. We need your help in picking out songs and to help us with that. Then coming up, May 1st, will be our quarterly business meeting. We will also have communion that Sunday. We will just do communion service, and then we'll do the business meeting. And then next week in the evening is our family Sunday, Finding the Point. We have a new episode that will be coming out. Going to be talking about confidence in God versus confidence in ourself. And how much better it is if we put our confidence and our trust in God than ourselves. Schedules for this week. Birthdays. We have April 24th. We have a birthday for Deanna. And then special music next week. April 24th is the ladies group. And then cleaning for this week, April 17th, is J. Mudge family. All right, I think that's all I have for announcements. So, brother, if you would come, and we'll give of our tithes and offerings back to the Lord. Would you pray for us, sir?
Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, we just thank you for this day. Thank you.
Well, let's begin our song service with 290. 290, The Power of the Cross. As you find that, please stand. Today, we're going to lay out the whole account of the resurrection. But this story starts before the resurrection. In fact, it starts before Jesus was born. It starts with Adam and Eve. God gave Adam and Eve a choice. Choose me in my way or reject me and choose you in your way. And they chose their way. And through them, sin came to all people. But God, through Jesus, sent Jesus to live as the perfect man, because perfect and imperfect, holy and unholy, cannot be together. And he sent Jesus to die on the cross for our sins, so that we can have a way to have fellowship with him, so that we can choose him and his way. And so we begin by singing The Power of the Cross. Oh, to see the dawn of the darkest day, Christ on the road to Calvary, tried by sinful men, born and beaten then, nailed to a cross of wood. This the power of the cross. Christ became for us, took the blame, bore the wrath, we stand forgiven at the cross. Oh, to see the pain written on your face, bearing the awesome weight of sin. The cross, Christ became sin for us, took the blame, bore the wrath, we stand forgiven at the cross. And the third, now the daylight flees, now the ground beneath wakes as its maker bows his head. Curtain torn in two, dead are raised to life. Finish the victory cry. This the power of the cross. Christ became for us, took the blame, bore the wrath, we stand forgiven at. And the last, oh, to see my name written in the wounds, for through your suffering I am free. To death, life is mine to live, won through your selfless love. This the power of the cross, Son of God, slain for us. What a cost, we stand forgiven at the cross. You may be seated. We begin our journey at the cross. This is where the story as we pick it up, not just a story, but a historical account begins. 324, we're going to sing, picks it up at the cross, and it tells us the whole story, asking, were you there when he was on the cross? Were you there when they laid him in the tomb, ending with the empty tomb? So let's sing 324, were you there? Were you there when they crucified my Lord? Were you there when they crucified my Lord? From the cross to the grave to the empty tomb, and now we sing in praise to the Lord, number 327, he lives, Matthew 28:6, he is not here, for he is risen. Stand with me on this one, please.
I serve a risen Savior, he's in the world today. I know that he is living, whatever men may say. I see his hand of mercy, I hear his voice of cheer, and just the time I need him, he's always near.
nice and loud.
Salvation to impart. You ask me how I know he lives. He lives within my heart.
On the second.
In all the world around me, I see his loving care. And though my heart grows weary, I never will despair. I know that he is near. All the stormy clouds, the day of his appearing will come. Jesus lives today. He walks with me and talks with me. Life's narrow way. He lives, salvation to impart. You ask me how I know he lives. He lives.
Rejoice, O Christian, lift up your voice and sing. Eternal hallelujahs to Jesus Christ the King, the hope of all who seek him, the help of all who find. None other is so loving, so good.
Rejoice nice and loud. He lives, Christ Jesus lives today. He walks with me and talks with me along life's narrow way. He lives, salvation to impart. You ask me how.
You can have a seat. We're going to have a special at this time, and then we're going to sing a couple more songs.
How can it be? Born our sin through sacrifice to conquer every sting of death. Sing, sing alleluia.
For joy awakes as dawning light when Christ's disciples lift their eyes. Alive he stands their friend. Christ, Christ, he is risen.
Christ is risen, he is risen indeed. Oh, sing hallelujah. Join the chorus, sing with the redeemed. Christ is risen, he is risen indeed.
For doubt and darkness once had been, they saw him and their hearts believed. But blessed are those who have not seen, yet sing hallelujah.
Once bound by fear, now bold in faith, they preach the truth and power of grace, and pouring out their lives they gained life, life everlasting.
Christ. Christ is risen, he is risen indeed. All sing hallelujah. Join the chorus, sing with the redeemed. Christ is risen, he is risen indeed. The power that raised him from the grave now works in us to powerfully save. He frees our hearts to live his grace. Go tell of his goodness. Christ is risen, he is risen indeed. All sing hallelujah. Join the chorus, sing with the redeemed. Christ is risen, he is risen indeed. Christ is risen, he is risen indeed. All sing hallelujah. Join the chorus, sing with the redeemed. Christ is risen, he is risen indeed.
Because he is risen, because he lives, the song says, I can face tomorrow. Isn't that truth? That's where we get the power as believers. Because of the resurrection, we have hope in tomorrow. We have hope in the things to come. And this would not be if it was not for his resurrection. So let's sing now, 387, Because He Lives.
God sent his son, they called him Jesus. He came to love, heal and forgive. He lived and died to buy my pardon. An empty grave is there to prove my Savior lives. Because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all fear is gone. Because I know he holds the future, and life is worth the living just because he lives. How sweet to hold a newborn baby and feel the pride and joy he gives. But greater still, the calm assurance this child can face uncertain days, because he lives. Because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all fear is gone. Because I know he holds a future, and life is worth the living just
and on the third.
And then one day I'll cross the river, I'll fight life's fight, no war with pain. And then as death gives way to victory,
nice and loud.
Because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all fear is gone. Because I know and life is worth the living just because he lives.
Amen. That chorus just speaks to me. Because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all fear is gone. Because I know he holds the future. And life is worth the living just because he lives. Let's sing now 599. Jesus came and died on the cross for our sins. He was buried in the tomb. 3 days later, he rose again. And it's through his resurrection that we have power in life. But it's also because now he is in heaven. He is sitting at the right hand of God. And we can come before the throne of God above. 599. Stand with me, please.
Before the throne of God above, I have a strong and perfect plea. A great high priest whose name is love, whoever pleads and prays for me. My name is graven on his hands, my name is written on his heart. I know that while in heaven he stands, no tongue can bid me thence depart. No tongue can bid me thence depart.
On the second,
when Satan tempts me to despair, avails me of the guilt within. Upward I look and see him there, who made an end of all my sin. Because the sinless Savior died, my sinful soul is counted free. For God the just is satisfied to look on him and pardon me. Look on him and pardon.
In the third,
behold him there, the risen Lamb, spotless righteousness, the great unchangeable I am, the King of glory and of grace. One in himself I die. My soul is purchased by his blood. My life is hid with Christ on high, with Christ my Savior and my God. With Christ my Savior and my God.
Amen. You can have a seat. Before we begin in our the dramatic reading here today, I would like to pray and just seek the Lord that he would speak to our hearts through the reading of his word. Lord God, as we come here this morning, we've sung praises and worship to you of your Son, of his death, his burial, and his resurrection. Lord, as we read and hear of the resurrection and the power in it, Lord, speak to us. I just ask that you would use it to be an impact in our lives. Lord, be glorified and honored in this. In Jesus' name, amen. My God, why hast thou forsaken me? Why art thou so far from helping me and from the words of my roaring? Oh, my God, I cry in the daytime, but thou hearest not. And in the night season am not silent, but thou art holy. O thou that inhabitest the praises of Israel, our fathers trusted in thee. They trusted and thou didst deliver them. They cried unto thee and were delivered. They trusted in thee and were not confounded. But I am a worm, and no man, a reproach of men, and despised of the people. All they that see me laugh me to scorn. They shoot out the lip, they shake the head, saying, he trusted on the Lord that he would deliver him, but let him deliver him, seeing he delighted in him. But thou art he that took me out of the womb. He didst make me hope. And when I was upon my mother's breast, I was cast upon thee from the womb. Thou art my God from my mother's belly. Be not far from me, for trouble is near. For there is none help. Many bulls have compassed me. Strong bulls of Bashan have beset me round. They gaped upon me with their mouths as a ravening and a roaring lion. I am poured out like water, and all my bones are out of joint. My heart is like wax. It is melted in the midst of my bowels. My strength is dried up like a potsherd. And my tongue cleaveth to my jaws, and thou hast brought me into the dust of death. For dogs have compassed me. The assembly of the wicked have enclosed me. They pierced my hands and my feet. I may tell all my bones. They look and stare upon me. They part my garments among them and cast lots upon my vesture. But be not thou not far from me, O Lord. O my strength, haste thee to help me. Deliver my soul from the sword, my darling from the power of the dog. Save me from the lion's mouth, for thou hast heard me from the horns of the unicorns. I will declare thy name unto my brethren. In the midst of the congregation will I praise thee. Ye that fear the Lord, praise him. All ye the seed of Jacob, glorify him. And fear him, all ye seed of Israel. For he hath not despised nor abhorred the affliction of the afflicted. Neither hath he hid his face from him. But when he cried unto him, he heard. My praise shall be of thee in the great congregation. I will pay my vows before them that fear him. When the even was come, there came a rich man of Arimathea, named Joseph, who also himself was Jesus' disciple. He went to Pilate and begged the body of Jesus. Then Pilate commanded the body to be delivered. And when Joseph had taken the body, he wrapped it in a clean linen cloth and laid it in his own new tomb, which he had hewn out in the rock. And he rolled a great stone to the door of the sepulchre and departed. And there was Mary Magdalene and the other Mary sitting over against the sepulchre. Now the next day that followed the day of the preparation, the priests, the chief priests and Pharisees came together unto Pilate, saying, Sir, we remember that that deceiver, while he was yet alive, after 3 days I will rise again. Command, therefore, that the sepulchre be made sure until the third day. Let his disciples come by night and steal him away and say unto the people, he is risen from the dead, so the last error shall be worse than the first. Pilate said unto them, Ye have a watch. Go your way. Make it as sure as you can. So they went and made the sepulcher sure, sealing the stone and setting a watch. In the end of the Sabbath, as it began to dawn toward the first day of the week, came Mary Magdalene and the other Mary to the sepulcher. And behold, there was a great earthquake, for the angel of the Lord descended from heaven and came and rolled back the stone from the door and sat upon it. His countenance was like lightning and his raiment white as snow. And for fear of him, the keepers did shake and became as dead men. Now when they were going, behold, some of the watch came into the city and showed unto the chief priests all the things that were done. And when they were assembled with the elders and had taken counsel, they gave large money unto the soldiers, saying, Say ye, his disciples came by night and stole him away while he slept. And if this comes to the governor's ears, we will persuade him and secure you. So they took the money and did as they were taught. And in this saying is commonly reported among the Jews until this day. And when the Sabbath was past, Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of James, and Salome had brought sweet spices, that they might come and anoint him. And very early in the morning, the first day of the week, they came unto the sepulchre at the rising of the sun, and they said among themselves, Who shall roll away the stone from the door of the sepulchre? And when they looked, they saw the stone was rolled away, for it was very great. And entering into the sepulchre, they saw a young man sitting on the right side, clothed in a long white garment, and they were affrighted. And saith unto them, Be not affrighted, ye seek Jesus of Nazareth, which was crucified. He is risen, he is not here. Behold the place where they laid him. But go your way, tell his disciples, and Peter, that he goeth before you into Galilee. There shall ye see him, as he said unto you. And they went out quickly and fled the sepulchre, for they trembled and were amazed. Neither said they anything to any man, for they were afraid. Then she runneth and cometh to Simon Peter and to the other disciple whom Jesus loved, and saith unto them, They have taken away the Lord out of the sepulchre, and we know not where they have laid him. Peter therefore went forth, and that other disciple, and came to the sepulchre. So they ran both together, and the other disciple did outrun Peter, and came first to the sepulchre. And he, stooping down and looking in, saw the linen clothes lying, yet he went not in. Then cometh Simon Peter following him, and went into the sepulchre, and seeth the linen clothes lie, and the napkin that was about his head, not lying with the linen clothes, but wrapped together in a place by itself. Then went in also the other disciple, which came first to the sepulchre, and he saw and believed. For as yet they knew not the scripture, that he must rise again from the dead. Then the disciples went away again unto their own house. But Mary stood without at the sepulchre weeping. And as she wept, she stood down and looked into the sepulchre, and seeth two angels in white sitting, the one at the head and the other at the feet, where the body of Jesus had lain. And they say unto her, Woman, why weepest thou? She saith unto them, Because they have taken away my Lord, and I know not where they have laid him. And when she said thus, she turned herself back and saw Jesus standing, and knew not that it was Jesus. Jesus saith unto her, Woman, why weepest thou? Whom seekest thou? She, supposing him to be the gardener, saith unto him, Sir, If thou have borne from him hence, tell me where thou hast laid him, and I will take him away. Jesus saith unto her, Mary. She turned herself and saith unto him, Rabboni, which is to say, Master. Jesus saith unto her, Touch me not, for I am not yet ascended to my Father. But go to my brethren and say unto them, I ascend unto my Father, and to your Father, and to my God, and your God. Mary Magdalene came and told the disciples that she had seen the Lord, and that she had spoken these things unto her. And behold, two of them that went that same day to a village called Emmaus, which was from Jerusalem about 80 furlongs. And they talked together all these things which had happened. And it came to pass that while they communed together and reasoned, Jesus himself drew near and went with them. But their eyes were holden that they should not know him. And he said unto them, What manner of communications are these that ye have one to another as ye walk and are sad? And one of them, whose name was Cleopas, answered and said unto him, Art thou only a stranger in Jerusalem, and hast not known the things that are come to pass there in these days? And he said unto them, What things? And they said unto him, Concerning Jesus of Nazareth, which was a prophet, mighty in deed and word before God and all the people, and how the chief priests and our rulers delivered him to be condemned to death and have crucified him. But we trusted that it had been he which should have redeemed Israel. And beside all this, today is the third day since these things were done. Yea, and a certain woman also of our company made us astonished, which were early at the sepulchre. And when they found not his body, they came, saying they had also seen a vision of angels, which said that he was alive. And certain of them which were with us went to the sepulchre and found it even so as the woman had said, but him they saw not. Then he said unto them, O fools, and slow of heart to believe all that the prophets have spoken. Ought not Christ to have suffered these things and to enter into his glory? And beginning at Moses and all the prophets, he expounded unto them all the scriptures, the things concerning himself. And they drew nigh unto the village whither they went, and he made as though he would have gone further. But they constrained him, saying, Abide with us, for it is toward evening, and the day is far spent. And he went to tarry with them. And it came to pass, as he sat at meat with them, he took bread and blessed it, and brake and gave to them. And their eyes were opened, and they knew him, and he vanished out of their sight. And they said one to another, Did not our heart burn within us while he talked with us by the way, and while he opened to us the scriptures? And they rose up the same hour and returned to Jerusalem, and found the 11 gathered together, and them that were with them, saying, The Lord is risen indeed, he hath appeared to Simon. And they told what things were done in the way, and how he was known of them in breaking of bread. And as they thus spoke, Jesus himself stood in the midst of them and saith unto them, Peace be unto you. But they were terrified and affrighted and supposed that they had seen a spirit. And he said unto them, Why are you troubled? And why do thoughts arise in your hearts? Behold, my hands and my feet, that it is I myself. Handle me and see. For a spirit hath not flesh and bones as ye see me have. And when he had thus spoken, he showed them his hands and feet. And while they yet believed not for joy and wondered, he said unto them, Have ye any meat? And they gave him a piece of a broiled fish and of an honeycomb, and he took it and did eat before them, and said unto them, These are the words which I spake unto you, while I was yet with you, that all things must be fulfilled, which were written in the law of Moses, and in the prophets, and in the Psalms concerning me. Then opened he their understanding, that they might understand the Scriptures, and said unto them, Thus it is written, and thus it behoved Christ to suffer and to rise from the dead the third day, and that repentance and remission of sins should be preached in his name among all nations, beginning at Jerusalem. And ye are witnesses of these things. And behold, I send the promise of my Father upon you, but tarry ye in the city of Jerusalem until ye be endued with power from on high. But Thomas, one of the 12, called Didymus, was not with them when Jesus came. The other disciples therefore said unto him, We have seen the Lord. But he said unto them, Except I shall see in his hands the print of the nails, and put my finger in the print of the nails, and thrust my hand into his side, I will not believe. And after 8 days, again, his disciples were within, and Thomas with them. Then came Jesus, the doors being shut, and stood in the midst, and said, Peace be unto you. Then saith he to Thomas, Reach hither thy finger, and behold my hands. Reach hither thy hand, and thrust it into my side, and be not faithless, but believing. And Thomas answered and said unto him, My Lord and my God. Jesus saith unto him, Thomas, because thou hast seen me, thou hast believed. Blessed are they that have not seen, and yet have believed. After these things, Jesus showed himself again to the disciples at the Sea of Tiberias, and on this wise showed he himself. There were together Simon Peter and Thomas called Didymus, and Nathanael of Cana in Galilee, and the sons of Zebedee, and two other of his disciples. Simon Peter saith unto them, I go a fishing. They say unto him, We also go with thee. They went forth and entered into a ship immediately, and that night they caught nothing. But when the morning was now come, Jesus stood on the shore. But the disciples knew not that it was Jesus. Then Jesus saith unto them, Children, have ye any meat? They answered him, No. And he said unto them, Cast the net on the right side of the ship, and ye shall find. And they cast therefore. And now they were not able to draw it for the multitudes of fishes. Therefore that disciple whom Jesus loved saith unto Peter, It is the Lord. Now when Simon Peter heard that it was the Lord, he girt his fisher's coat unto him, for he was naked, and cast himself into the sea. And the other disciples came in a little ship, for they were not far from land, but as it were 200 cubits, dragging the net with fishes. As soon as they were come to land, they saw a fire of coals there, and fish laid thereon, and bread. Jesus saith unto them, Bring of the fish which ye have now caught. Simon Peter went up and drew the net to land full of great fishes, 153. And for all there were so many, yet was not the net broken. Jesus saith unto them, Come and dine. And none of the disciples durst ask him, Who art thou? Knowing that that it was the Lord. Jesus then cometh and taketh bread and giveth them, and fish likewise. This now the third time that Jesus showed himself to his disciples. After that he was risen from the dead. The former treatise have I made, O Theophilus, of all that Jesus began both to do and teach, until the day in which he was taken up, after he, through the Holy Ghost, had given commandments unto the apostles whom he had chosen, to whom also he showed himself alive after his passion, by many infallible proofs, being seen of them 40 days, and speaking the things pertaining to the kingdom of God. And being assembled together with them, commanded them that they should not depart from Jerusalem, but wait for the promise of the Father, which saith he, Ye have heard of me. For John truly baptized with water, but ye shall be baptized with the Holy Ghost, not many days hence. When they therefore were come together, they asked of him, saying, Lord, wilt thou at this time restore again the kingdom to Israel? And he said unto them, It is not for you to know the times or the seasons which the Father hath put in his own power. But ye shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost is come upon you. And ye shall be witnesses unto me both in Jerusalem and in all Judea and in Samaria and unto the uttermost part of the earth. And when he had thus spoken these things, while they beheld, he was taken up. And a cloud received him out of their sight. And while they looked steadfastly toward heaven as he went up, behold, the two men stood by them in white apparel, which also said, Ye men of Galilee, why stand ye gazing up into heaven? This same Jesus, which is taken up from you into heaven, shall so come in like manner as ye have seen him go into heaven. He is not here, for he is risen, as he said. Now, please join me in standing, and let's sing number 46, I'll hail the power of Jesus' name.
With yonder sacred throng, we have
praise God for his great work in sending his son. At Christmas, we celebrate his birth. We've been studying in Luke through his life. And then his death, he died and suffered for each of us. I wonder sometimes in his infinite knowledge and infinite wisdom, did he see my face when he hung there? And then he died and was buried and he rose again. Go forth today and live in the and rejoice in the power, in the strength, in the joy and peace of the resurrection and the hope that we have, knowing that Jesus has risen from the grave and we want too will one day see him in glory if we know him as our Savior. Amen. Dad, would you close us in prayer?
Heavenly Father, thank you.